Hello friends. So in the previous three sessions, we have started with the basic principle of operation of the synchronous motor. Then we went to the equivalent circuit of the synchronous motor. And then we went for the magnetic perspective of the synchronous motor, in which we discussed the vector diagram of the synchronous motor as well. So today we are going to start a video on the steady state synchronous motor operation. There are many topics within the steady state synchronous motor operation. So today will be the first topic, and that is called the torque speed characteristics of the synchronous motor. So let's start with the session today. So the first thing that you have to understand before we discuss this topic is that the synchronous motors usually supply loads which are constant in nature. That is, they usually supply loads which require constant speed. Okay, that is what synchronous motor does. The synchronous motor can run at a constant speed. Therefore, the loads that they supply are usually constant speed loads. So that I'll write down here first. So the synchronous motor usually supplies constant speed loads. Okay, constant speed loads. One of the example of the constant speed loads is the machines which you find in paper mills and as well as in huge clothing mills. Okay, these are all usually constant speed loads. So this is the synchronous motor usually supplies constant speed loads. Second speed thing that you have to understand here is that usually the synchronous motor is connected to a power system. Okay, it is connected to a power supply, and this power supply is very large in comparison with this single synchronous motor that we are considering. Therefore, under all conditions of the synchronous motor, the voltage and frequency across the synchronous motor is constant. Okay, synchronous motor is constant. Okay, so it is like the synchronous motor is seeing this power system as an infinite bus. Okay, and the next third thing is that the speed of the synchronous motor is constant regardless of the load that is connected. Okay, regardless of the load that is connected. Okay, so whatever be the load across the shaft of the synchronous motor will rotate at the constant speed regardless of the load that is connected across the shaft. It is very clearly understood that the synchronous motor can only rotate at one speed, which is called the synchronous speed. Okay, because the basic working of the synchronous motor is magnetic locking between the stator magnetic field, the rotor magnetic field and the net magnetic field. So everything is in a magnetically locked position, and everything rotates at the same speed of the synchronous speed. So for a given machine with this given number of poles, so ns is equal to 120 f electrical divided by number of poles, and f electrical I have already made it constant here. Therefore, ns is going to be a constant value regardless of the load. So with all these three conditions together, if you plot a graph between the torque induced, okay, so if you plot a graph between the torque induced in the machine, okay, and the speed of the machine, let us call it as nm, synchronous motor can rotate at only one speed, and let us call it as nsync, synchronous speed. And whatever be the load condition, it can be this point, this point, this point, this point, or this point, the synchronous speed will rotate at the same speed. So for this point, it will be rotating at nsync. For this point, it will be rotating at nsync. For this point, it will be rotating at nsync. So I cannot draw the graph vertically towards infinity, right? There is some point where it has to stop. Okay. So if you draw the graph like this, okay, this should be a straight line ideally. It is very difficult to draw with this digital pen. Yeah. So I'll just try to make it a little bit more straight. Okay. So I think this is okay. Now there is a point where the machine will reach its rated torque. Okay. So the torque induced here is the rated torque with the machine. For example, this was the load demand. Okay. So this was the load demand. So the red line is the load demand, and that load will have a So in that load also the synchronous motor will rotate at synchronous speed, and at this point under steady state condition, torque load will be equal to torque induced. Another load condition it will be like this, another load condition will be like this, but at this load condition we say that the induced torque is the rated torque of the machine. So you should not ideally go beyond that, but there is a point you can go ideally beyond that till one point which is called the pull out torque of the synchronous machine. Okay, so the curve will not exist beyond that. We should not go beyond this particular pull out torque. Okay, so this is the maximum torque which can be induced in the machine. Okay, so this torque induced, if you want it in equation, it is K into BR B net into sine delta, right? This is a common equation which we have seen from synchronous generator. Another equation for torque induced will be equal to 3 into EA V phase sine delta divided by omega m into XS. So power output was equal to 3 EA V phase sine delta divided by XS, same as synchronous generator. So torque induced, we have to just to get torque induced, you have to divided by omega m. Okay, so now this pull out torque is an important thing here. Okay, oh yeah, before pull out torque, there is another thing which we have to discuss here, is the speed regulation. Speed regulation of the synchronous motor, what is that? It is no load speed minus the full load speed divided by the full load speed. Now the synchronous motor under no load or full load will rotate at only one speed, which is called a synchronous speed. Therefore this value will be same, n at no load and n at full load will be the same. Therefore the speed regulation of the synchronous motor will be 0%. Okay, it will be at 0%. Now let us see what is the maximum torque that can be derived out of the synchronous machine. You can clearly see from here, this equation here, the torque induced will be equal to the maximum torque, okay, when delta equal to 90 degree. It is a sine value, right? So delta equal to 90, sine delta will be equal to 1. So the maximum torque that can be derived out of the synchronous machine will be equal to K into BR B net, or it is also equal to this value here, right? 3 into EA V phase by omega m into XS. Okay, so this is the thing. Now this pull out torque is the maximum with the generator which can, what the motor can give, what that the torque that can be induced in the motor. Okay, so now usually this torque rated is very less as compared to the pull out torque. Okay, so usually the torque rated, okay, the torque rated is about, let me just write in the reverse there, the pull out torque will be equal to approximately 3 times the rated torque of the synchronous machine. So therefore you are having some kind of a margin here in case you tend to overload the machine. But usually in steady state condition you should always stay below this, because beyond this the current requirement will require to a very high value, which is not the rated current which can be flowed through the winding. But the motor can technically go till here, but if you go till here, there is a huge chance that the motor winding might get burnt off. Okay, so that is another thing. So now let us see what happens when the induced torque or the demand torque, induced torque, is greater than the pull out torque. That is, you are in this region here, okay, and the motor can only supply till this region here. Now so if the torque induced, okay, tends to be greater than the pull out torque, okay, so torque induced greater than the pull out torque means you are loading the generator shaft, sorry, motor shaft to a very high value. Okay, what happens here is that the rotor actually loses its magnetic locking with the net magnetic flux B net and also the stator rotating magnetic field. Right, these two things happen here. So let's understand this into a little bit depth. So in the magnetic perspective, you saw that if this value was the B net value, okay, this value is the BR value, and if you want to find the BS value, it will be the vector subtraction of B net and BS. Why? Because BR plus BS is equal to B net, right? Okay, so BS will be equal to B net minus BR. So if you just do the analysis, you will find that BS is this value. Now all these three things are locked together and they are together rotating at the synchronous speed, right? They are together rotating at the synchronous speed. Now when the, now this is the case when the torque induced is less than the torque pull out torque. Okay, pull out torque. Now in case the pull out the torque induced is more than the pull out torque, that means the load is so high on the motor, what happens is that this BR, okay, the BR is at this position because the torque induced in the machine is able to meet the load. Now if it is not able to meet the load, what happens? It will never reach this steady state position. It will be continuously decelerating, and it will be coming behind this position. So what happens, let us see here. So this is the B net value, and this is continuously changing its position because the torque demand is so high that the induced torque is not able to match the load demand. So what happens is that this magnetic locking is lost, okay, and everything is not rotating together at synchronous speed. So what happens at this point, let us see what is the torque induced. So at this point, the torque induced is in this direction, right? So this point, the torque induced is in this direction, so everything is okay. But you know that because the rotor is now losing its speed, it is decelerating, but omega, but BS and B net are rotating at the synchronous speed, at a higher speed. So after some time, what will happen? So because the rotor is rotating, the BR is now rotating at a slower speed because it's decelerating. Now after some time, what will happen? This BS value might come to this point here. Okay. So the BS value might come to this point here. Okay. And the B net also correspondingly, it will come somewhere around here. This is another point in time. Okay. This is another point in time. So what will be the torque induced now? So torque induced is BR cross B net or BR cross BS. So now the torque induced is in this direction. The torque induced is in this direction. So after time, sometime BS will overtake BR. It will come to this position. Okay. So if you find the induced torque again, so it will be in the opposite direction. So basically what is happening is that there is a huge torque fluctuation inside the synchronous motor because the rotor is rotating at a slower speed because the induced torque is not able to meet the load. So it is gradually decelerating, but BS and B net are rotating at the synchronous speed. So this will cause continuous torque fluctuations in the machine, and it will cause the synchronous motor to vibrate heavily. Okay, so the rotor of the machine will start to vibrate heavily. So if you want to write it as a point here, I will write it so that as the rotor slows down, the stator magnetic field, laps it. Laps in the sense it is continuously crossing it. Laps it repeatedly, not once but many times, and the direction of the torque induced, reverses at every pass, and that is what I just explained here. So at this position, the torque induced is in this direction. In this position, the torque induced is in this direction. So one time anti-clockwise, another time clockwise. Okay. So what is the result of this? The result is that huge torque surges. Okay, the huge torque surges occurs, and the rotor vibrates heavily. Okay. Now, this loss of synchronism between the rotor flux, the magnetic field, the stator magnetic field, and the B net is called slipping poles. Okay, this is called slipping poles. So if somebody asks you this question, you can give this particular definition. We have already seen what is the maximum torque value, right? So we have already seen what is the maximum torque value. So the torque max will be either equal to K into BR into B net, okay, or it is also equal to 3 into EA V phase divided by omega M into XS. So these are the two equations of the torque max. You can clearly see if you want a higher torque max, higher torque pullout, you cannot change V phase. You cannot change omega M and you cannot change omega X, so XS. These are constant value. The only way is to change EA, because EA is equal to K phi omega. That means EA is a function of the field current. Therefore, if you have a motor which is operating at a higher field current, the torque max will be higher. Okay, so the pullout torque will be higher. Therefore, there is a stability advantage here. That is, you are having a stability advantage when the motor is operated at a higher EA or a higher field current. Okay. So there is a stability advantage. If the motor is rotated, operated at a higher EA or IF. Both are the same thing. So what I mean to say here is that, so if this is the torque pullout 1 at IF 1, okay, so if IF 2 is greater than IF 1, so the motor can technically go up to this point here. Okay, so this will be the torque pullout 2 at IF 2, and IF 2 is greater than IF 1. Okay, so there is an inherent stability advantage as compared to this point here, in case the motor tends to overload. So with that, let us conclude today's session. And the next session, we will be starting with the effect or different effects like the load change and the field current change, etc. What effects it has on the synchronous motor. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Don't forget to watch the other videos, which are the engineering circuit analysis, AC machines and also the DC machines, which is a complete course now, and synchronous generators, etc. on the channel. Please recommend the videos to your friends as well. So till I see you in the next video, it's me, Varun, signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.